L-carnitine, or acetyl L-carnitine, is an amino acid that plays a huge role in the body in energy production, converting fat into energy. In fact, it's an amino acid celebrity and is one of the most popular supplements on the market, since it's been studied to enhance athletic performance, to bring fat burning to the next level, help with osteoarthritis, slow down Alzheimer's disease, help in cardiovascular disease, and so much more. And while many of us get our carnitine from our diets, mainly in fish, red meats, and poultry, avocados, and peanuts, it's also available in capsules, liquids, or as an injection form to get a concentrated dose, which some of you are wondering about if it's worth taking. In this video, instead of going into all of the benefits of L-carnitine, which I can make a separate video about, I'm gonna talk about how L-carnitine works exactly, the safety of L-carnitine in terms of how much is safe to take, the side effects that you need to know of, and the potential risks of taking carnitine supplements that you should not ignore. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into it. You see, L-carnitine is a type of carnitine which comes from amino acids. And when amino acids combine, they form proteins in order to do a specific task in the body. And one of the main tasks for L-carnitine is to turn fatty acids into energy to power the cells. And the good news is that, generally speaking, in most people, the body makes enough of it on its own. The liver and kidneys create L-carnitine from the amino acids lysine and methionine. But in other cases, some people are at risk for lower levels of carnitine. For example, if you have angina or intermittent claudication, or are a vegan or a vegetarian, your levels of carnitine may be lower and you may have been recommended to try out a carnitine supplement. And yes, there are different types that are studied for different use cases. For example, acetyl L-carnitine, which is useful for benefiting brain health and memory, since it's able to pass the blood-brain barrier, which is why it was studied for Alzheimer's disease. Propionyl L-carnitine, which helps increase nitric oxide, which dilates the blood vessels, giving better blood flow. And L-carnitine L-tartrate, which is found in your sports supplements, reducing that sore muscle that you can get and giving you the edge on performance. So the type of carnitine will vary based on what it is you're actually trying to target. Oh, and an important thing to mention, you want to avoid the D-carnitine supplements as they interfere with the natural form of L-carnitine. And when it comes to the amount that is safe to take, here's the issue I have. With the two main forms of carnitine, in L-carnitine and acetyl L-carnitine, the amounts range from anywhere from 3 milligrams to 5,000 milligrams. You see the problem now? That's a wide range. Carnitine doesn't have a well-established tolerable upper intake level, so that's a big question and what a lot of people are wondering. What is the best dose to stick to that is still safe and effective? Well, based on the research available, a dose of up to 2 grams per day is mostly used with at least amount of side effects, which makes sense since the general standard you hear about L-carnitine is anywhere from 500 to 2,000 milligrams daily anyway, which is a little different for acetyl L-carnitine, right? Since you see doses up to 2,500 milligrams per day, and for L-carnitine L-tartrate for athletes, typically can go all the way up to 4 to 5 grams. And the higher the dose goes up, the more side effects you will experience. And speaking of side effects, let's get into them because I need you to know what they are. And there's 4 main ones: stomach cramps, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Which is why it may be best to work with a lower strength than work your way up to a higher strength. Interestingly, when you get to the 3000 milligram or the 3 gram level, something bizarre happens. You can start smelling like a fish. A fishy body odor, the literature tells us, so do be aware of that. Further than this, we know that carnitine helps preserve muscle glycogen and lowers muscle soreness, but if you have uremia and kidney dysfunction, it can play the opposite effect and cause muscle weakness and causes seizures in those who have a seizure disorder, which are all important factors that can't be ignored. Now that we discussed the dosing, the side effects, and who it is not suited for, I want to turn our attention to what happens to the unabsorbed carnitine, which is often ignored in other videos. There is some research, some ideally I would like more, but some research does indicate that intestinal bacteria metabolize the unabsorbed carnitine to form what's called TMAO and gamma-butyrobetaine, which might increase the risk of cardiovascular disease. This ties back into the controversy with eggs and choline and their effects on TMAO as well. Does the choline in eggs increase your cardiovascular problems too? It's much more complicated than that, and until more research comes out on this, I'm considering TMAO as just a bystander and not the cause of the disease. Because think about it, TMA is found in fish, and fish oil, which is actually recommended to protect you against cardiovascular disease. And to put it all together, if I were to start a carnitine supplement, I would start with a low dose, increase it slowly to see how my body tolerates it over time. And with many negative side effects that are out there, be sure to report them to your doctor. And if you're using it to enhance the fat loss and weight loss, be sure to use it in combination with a healthy diet and active lifestyle to see the most results. I would love to hear your thoughts down below too. If you found this useful, share with me your feedback or share this video with others. Click the subscribe button too if you found any value, and I'll see you on the next one.